Tell us a little bit about the way in which you came to this piece that you've been working on, Slow Fade to Black, and also the Mary Lou Williams project that you're going to play for us tonight.
Well, firstly, thank you so much for inviting me and the trio to participate in this historic event. And it's been such an inspiration hearing all of this brilliance and seeing all this creative thought and you sharing your light in this way. So thank you so much.
Let's start with the Mary Lou Williams project.
Well, you and I have been working together in different settings now for, I don't know, about 3, 4 years, maybe 5. Yes, and it's been an amazing journey.
Can you hear a different voice than the Astros?
We started with a flying toward the sound.
Oh, that's right.
And through Motema, Jana Hertzen, I met you through Kunle Mwanga.
Right. Right.
Who brought us together. Of course, I knew your work, and it was the idea of so exciting to have an opportunity to work closely together. But you created a whole nother dimension for me as an artist.
I didn't think about that.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes, you have. And to see visually the work come to life in the kinds of ways that you were able to just pinpoint my emotions that are happening in the music without us really talking about it. It's incredible. So now I'm seeing the music and these beautiful images represented. So that's really
in
how
flying
it,
for the sound.
Yes,
the first piece that we worked on together.
That's right.
Yeah, that was almost 4 years ago, almost 5 years ago. That's right.
Right.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
And then you had this like amazing project with Jason Moran, who played last night, which was really wonderful.
Yeah.
Vijay Iyer, who played yesterday morning, which is really beautiful. How did this collaboration come about with your working through this collaborative project and thinking about Mary Lou?
Right, right. Well, and you were involved. I'm so excited that we had all of these dimensions. The idea was to bring together scholars, Mary Lou Williams scholars, who could participate in furthering the dialogue about her contribution and how important a pivotal figure she is in American music. Mm-hmm. And so we had
many of you who don't know Mary Lou Williams, of course, is the a female jazz pianist.
Yeah, she was so many. Her career spanned decades and decades. Probably, she was the artist whose career spanned and where she exploded through different eras. You know, supporting the breakthroughs of great innovators of those eras. People like Bud Powell and Thelonious Monk. She mentored. So there are. There's some very important work and research being done on her. Farrah Jasmine Griffin's new book, Harlem Nocturne, has an amazing chapter that brings new light to Mary Lou as a figure, really making inroads not only musically but in terms of her humanitarian connections with the community that she lived at Harlem Terrace, and so we know all the stories about her home and how that was a place for these brilliant innovative minds to kind of
to gather
and share ideas about new thought that they were having about music. And so we know about that, but there were other aspects of her that I didn't know about in terms of how she just contributed to supporting musicians who were struggling through, all kinds of addictions or different challenges. And and Dwight Andrews also, contributed as a scholar. And then Vijay, as you mentioned, Vijay and Jason We all play together.
In different locations.
Different locations.
Simulcast together, right?
That's
there were like five or six different locations.
That's right, that's right. So we had, through the Internet 2 technology, it allowed us to all improvise simultaneously from Boston. We had San Francisco. We had a hookup in Michigan. So Vijay was in at Harvard,
right.
And Jason was at Columbia, and I was in Pittsburgh. And so we're improvising, looking at your film footage as a source of inspiration, creating something with a very a slight kinds of delay that we were experiencing. But what you see on CNN, for instance, when people are in other parts of the world and there's this slow delay,
the voice comes back.
Well, they have created this, through this technology, it shortens that distance. So we were able to really play pretty much in real time.
It's fabulous. And so we're gonna hear some of that tonight.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Thank you. I'd like to invite my trio to the bandstand. We have on bass, is Kenny there? Kenny Davis. And on drums, we have Kassa Overall. This first piece is inspired by the great Alice Coltrane, and it's called Swamini. Thank you. Thank you. So we'd like to continue now with Slow Fade to Black.
Thank you. Carrie Mae Weems. Thank you. Kassa. We'd like to now feature Kenny Davis on a ballad, something that we wrote for Dr. Taylor called Open-Handed Reach. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Kenny Davis. We'd like to continue now with Carrie May's film, Mary Lou Williams, that we spoke about a moment ago. And I was wondering if you could roll the film. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We set that piece to Mary Lou Williams' Fungus Among Us. So that theme that you heard reoccurring was her composition, her melody. And we'd like to close our portion of the evening with something called LWB's House. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you. Thank you so much. On behalf of Kenny Davis, Kassa Overall. Thank you. Thank you, Carrie.